And from the U, number 66, Justin Renfrow. Offensive lineman from UMass, number 95, Shaquille Holiness. Fullback from Camden County High School and FIU, number 18, Anthony Johnson. Wide receiver from University Christian School and FAU, number 3, Jensen Stojan. Wide receiver from Mandarin High School and FAU, number 6, Cameron Solomon. He's back at wide receiver from Tennessee State, double uno, Devin Wilson. And your starting quarterback from Bethel University, number 2, Sam Castronova. The head coach of your Jacksonville Sharks, Jason Gibson. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your Jacksonville Sharks. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would you please rise? And gentlemen, please remove your hats as we honor America and those who serve our country at home and abroad with a presentation of tonight's colors. The colors for this evening's contest are being presented by the NAS Jacksonville Color Guard. Fans, please remain standing as local recording artist and lead singer of Neon Whiskey, Sarah Benjamin, performs our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting. Gave proof through the night
here set for an exciting night of arena football action as the Jacksonville Sharks and Orlando Predators square off for the second time in as many weeks. Jacksonville traveled down to Orlando, came away with a 67-44 victory, and the game really wasn't that close against Orlando last week. That victory helped pull the Sharks into first place in the NAL standings by virtue of holding the tiebreaker over the San Antonio Gunslingers. 3 weeks left in the 2023 regular season, and a lot to play for still. With home turf on the line, the Carolina Cobras are lingering just a game and a half behind San Antonio and Jacksonville. But the Sharks trying to maintain that first place position as they square off against Orlando tonight. And actually getting underway at just about the same time up in Greensboro, North Carolina, will be the Gunslingers and the Cobras. So the top four teams in the NAL in action tonight, the West Texas Warbirds are off, and we will certainly follow the action in Carolina as well, as things may move around here as the teams try and get that home field advantage for at least the first round of the playoffs. The captains for both teams on the field as we are just about set for action here in the Shark Tank. Jacksonville, winners of six consecutive games. It's been a bit of an interrupted season with some bye weeks, some changing around of the schedule, but one thing has been consistent over these past 2 months or so, and that is the play of quarterback Sam Castronova. Has not thrown an interception since joining Jacksonville. Castronova, if you count his time with the Albany Empire, leads the league in touchdowns and passing yards in basically every quarterback category. He is completing over 70% of his passes since joining Jacksonville, 37 touchdowns in six games. So you can pretty much pencil in Castronova and the Sharks for six touchdowns through the air, and that gets you pretty close to the 50-plus point margin. Jacksonville comes in as the league leader in the NAL in points scored and margin of victory and overall point differential as well. Jacksonville scored 647 points through 10 games, so easy math there, averaging 64 points per contest. San Antonio in second place has just a plus 4 point differential, averaging 48 points a game. So this Jacksonville offense and an opportunistic defense, I should say, has combined to put this team in a good position. The Sharks' only two losses, the first two games here at home, each of them by 1 point in overtime. They've won every other game by a fairly comfortable margin. Again, that 23-point victory last week. The Sharks have won the toss. They will be back to receive. The Sharks will be back to receive the opening kickoff of the third quarter as they win the toss and they defer their choice, I believe.
All right. Despite the controversial coin toss, Jacksonville has won the toss and elected to defer their options. The Predators will receive the ball.
So we'll see the Orlando Predator offense on the field first. As Jacksonville will kick off and be back to receive the opening kickoff of the third quarter. The Sharks open the season all the way back on April 8th with a comfortable victory over the West Texas Warbirds. And again, they alternated wins and losses the first four games of the season. Those 2 1-point losses here at home, including their last defeat at the hands of this very Orlando Predator team, 61-60, back on April 30th. Since then, Jacksonville has put up at least 58 points in every game. They've scored 60-plus in five of these six wins. And in fact, in all but two games this season, Jacksonville has eclipsed the 60-point mark. They've won every game by at least 9 points. That won a 9-point victory over the Carolina Cobras a couple of weeks ago. And Jacksonville's been firing all cylinders, but this is a hungry Orlando team that's played better football of late. The Predators actually knocked off the San Antonio Gunslingers a few weeks ago. That's one of the reasons Jacksonville now finds itself in first place. Nick Belcher on the field for the Sharks. Jacksonville wearing their home red uniforms with the white helmets. Orlando in the road whites, black helmets, black pants. Darius Prince, league leader in touchdown receptions this season with 27. He also serves as the primary kickoff returner for Orlando. He'll be back to receive as we're just a few seconds away from kickoff here in the Shark Tank. Second to last home game of the season, the Sharks will host the West Texas Warbirds this time next week before heading up to Carolina for a matchup against the Carolina Cobras to end the 2023 regular season. But a lot to play for here in these last 3 weeks. It's the 8-2 Sharks, the 4-6 Predators, and we are officially underway as Belcher sends an end-over-end kick left to right on your screen. Prince will field it off the rebound net. He'll try the right side, slipping out of one tackle, but only getting out to about the 7-yard line. Gets thrown forward by Trey Harlan, but solid kickoff coverage for Jacksonville. It was Jensen Stoshak, the first man down there, to kind of slow up the return, give the rest of his team time to catch up, corral Prince. And Orlando will start just outside the 5-yard line. Danny Southwick will be under center for the Predators here to start this game. Southwick and Rakeem Cato both saw significant action last week. This is Southwick's fourth appearance since joining the Orlando Predators, a guy that's been playing a long time here in arena football. As Southwick sends Prince in motion, it'll be Darius Prince, the first reception of the game, but Jabari Gorman is there for a quick tackle at about the 10-yard line, a gain of 3. Jabari Gorman leads the league in solo tackles, also in interceptions. Playing that field corner spot, sees a lot of action, and more often than not, he's up the task as he was there on first down. Trevante Long, Lonnie Outlaw, and Darius Prince, the three receivers for Orlando to start this game. It's Outlaw in motion here on 2nd and 7. They'll blow this one dead. Pre-snap movement. Orlando pointing the direction of Jeremiah Price.
Prior to the snap, neutral zone infraction. Defense, number 9. 5-yard penalty. It remains 2nd down.
And it is offside called against Price. That helps out Orlando, turns a 2nd and 7 into 2nd and 2 with the ball now up at the 15-yard line. Southwick hands it off to Mitchell, and the Orlando fullback breaks free into Jacksonville territory all the way down to the 15-yard line. Excuse me, Desmond Maxwell. Got the handoff, and at first it looked like he did not have a ton of running room. You'll see here as Maxwell just gets around the corner. Harlan can't make the tackle. Stoshak didn't want much of that either. And that big 20-yard run puts Orlando in business. Now Prince in motion, new set of downs for Southwick. Quick pass to the right. Caught there by Outlaw, another short gain. Gorman again on the tackle. Gain of 4, it's going to be 2nd down and 6. Jabari Gorman, Marvin Ross, Jensen Stoshak, your defensive backs for Jacksonville, Devin Wilson, playing the Jack linebacker spot here on this first series. Southwick looking left, fires, has a man along the wall again. Outlaw, basically the same thing in the opposite direction as Gorman makes the stop on Outlaw right along the wall. It's a short gain, 3rd down and about 2. Not sure if it was the exact same play call reversed, but it looked exactly the same in terms of quarterback and receiver. Lonnie Outlaw, of course, plenty of size to work with, listed at 6'7", 224. Now it's long in motion, third down and short. Hand off to Maxwell, and he'll get tripped up. Does not get the first down. Trey Harlan was the first guy in there. Was able to corral Maxwell around the lower half, take him down, and just like that, it's fourth down for Orlando. A pivotal fourth and two here in the opening moments of this game. 4 minutes in, first possession. As Orlando needs the 5 yard line, they have it at the 7. They reset the play clock. Prince in motion. Southwick, it's intercepted, and that's going to be a walk-in touchdown for Jabari Gorman. Gorman jumps the route, goes the distance, and Jacksonville leads 6-0. The league leader in picks gets number 7 and gets his team on the board with a defensive touchdown. Here we'll have a look. Southwick, quick toss to the right, and Gorman knew exactly what was coming. Nothing Orlando could do after he picked that clean. Not only do the Sharks get the stop, they get a stop and an immediate score on the pick six. And now Belcher is on to try and make this a 7-0 ball game. They reset the play clock as the Sharks are running an offensive lineman off the field. Wilson the snap, Stoshak the hold, the kick is up and right down the middle. Belcher connects, and it's 7-0, 10:08 to go in the first quarter. The pick six by Jabari Gorman puts the Sharks up early. We'll be back in a moment here on YouTube Live.
High-five your favorite players as the Sharks prepare to take the field for battle. Enjoy a catered pre-game, all-you-can-eat buffet in our private Duval room, perfect for networking and entertaining. Then, just before kickoff, you'll head into the tunnel outside the Sharks locker room to greet the players as they head out for pregame introductions.
Been cutting since 1990.
There's something special about cooking out in the backyard. Beautiful out here today. There's nothing like cooking home with your family and sharing food with the people that I love. Barbecue is all about bringing people together.
Because everybody loves barbecue.
Are you looking for a place to host your next corporate outing, date night, family fun night? Sharks have you covered. Sharks Reef Field Suites are the most exciting place to watch a sporting event here in Jacksonville. You can't get any closer to the action. Each Reef Suite includes food and holds up to 8 people. Create memories you'll never forget. Give me a call, 904-621-0700, extension 702, or email me, dave@jacksharks.com, to secure your Reef Suite. I promise you, these will sell out, so don't delay. Purchase your Reef Suite today.
And we're back in the Shark Tank. 7-0 Jacksonville on top of Orlando after the interception return for a touchdown by Jabari Gorman. And now Nick Belcher, for the second time tonight, will send a kick in the direction of Darius Prince, who feels this one shy of the net. He'll head right up the middle to start this return with a bit of running room out across the 20-yard line before he's taken down by Holiness. It's a good return by Darius Prince and solid field position for Orlando. USAA is proudly celebrating 100 years of serving the military community since 1922. USAA has grown from a group of soldiers who joined together to insure each other's vehicles because no other companies would, to more than 13 million members strong. And through it all, one thing has remained. USAA is still serving the military and their families. Find out more at USAA.com. We'll see how Danny Southwick bounces back from the interception. They pitch it to Maxwell on first down, and the Predator fullback charges forward for a solid pickup. Russell on the tackle for Jacksonville, but it's a gain of 5 or 6 yards for Desmond Maxwell. It's been a healthy diet of the run game for Orlando so far tonight. The Predators only average 19.3 rushing yards per game, which is fairly low here in the NAL. Maxwell, though, 55 carries through 10 games, already has 3 or 4 tonight. They'll hand it to Maxwell again, and he's got first down yardage as he slides up the middle. Bit of a counter play there by the Predator offense. 2 carries, 11 yards. Holiness on the tackle, but not before it's first down yardage for Maxwell. They'll hand it to Maxwell for a third time, and Jacksonville on this occasion ready for it. Russell, Holiness, and Johnson all there on the tackle. You see, this third time, the Sharks were not fooled at all. Orlando did gain a yard, but if you're Jacksonville, you'll take that 2nd and 9. They send Outlaw and Prince split to the left. Long, the lone receiver to the short side right. Southwick sends Outlaw in motion. Quick pass over to Prince, who hauls it in. Gets around the corner inside the 5-yard line. He'll get tackled into the wall at about the 1. Devin Wilson in pursuit, but a nice move there by Darius Prince, who gets around the corner. Outlaw throwing a block on Gorman. And now the Predators have 1st and goal from the 1-yard line. Southwick hands it to Maxwell, who's into the end zone for a Predator touchdown. Not a whole lot you can do there if Maxwell gets a tiny bit of running room with his size. And Orlando bounces back from the interception by getting on the board with a touchdown on the 1-yard run by fullback Desmond Maxwell. Dylan Bardis, left-footed place kicker, on for the first time tonight for Orlando. And his kick is up and good. The Predators answer the Jacksonville defensive touchdown with an offensive touchdown of their own. We're more than halfway through the first quarter. Sam Castronova and the Shark offense has not seen the field yet. It's 7-7 here in the Shark Tank.
Contest, take it away, Steph.
All right, tonight, normally I feel like this side of the arena doesn't get any love. So if you're in section 115, 114, or 113, stand to your feet. Who wants some t-shirts? Okay, section 114, have a seat. Sorry, it's really good for you to get up. It's okay. All right, section 115. Section 113, I can't hear you. Okay, section 115, sit down. Okay, this promotion is presented by Metro Diner. So if you are in row M for Metro Diner, you guys are tonight's lucky row. Congratulations.
7-7 the score. Barnes has the ball teed up. Cameron Solomon back for the first time as the Jacksonville kick returner. The Sharks have seven guys pulled up, maybe expecting something from Orlando here, and it is going to be a high hop onside kick, but it sails into the stands, and Jacksonville will get possession and a point, I believe. It didn't go out of bounds in the air, but it did go out, obviously, wide of the rebound net structure.
A little kick out of bounds. Kicking team, number 15. The ball will be spotted at the outbound spot. 1 point will be awarded to Jacksonville. First down and 10 at the outbound spot.
So that's the new rule in the NAL this year. If a kickoff goes out of bounds, essentially wide of the rebound net or shy of the end line, then it's 1 point to the receiving team. And so Jacksonville with good field position and an 8-7 lead. Solomon in motion for Sam Castronova. His first pass of the game is complete to Solomon up the middle. And Cameron Solomon gets to about the 4-yard line. First and goal for Jacksonville. Just about the most successful quarterback-receiver combination in the NAL this season. Cameron Solomon, 90-plus catches, 25 touchdowns. Second in the league in both categories if you include Darius Prince's combined time with Orlando and Albany, but it's pretty much neck and neck between those two receivers. Castronova, of course, 37 touchdowns, many of those to Cameron Solomon, who gets the handoff here on first and goal, and Cameron Solomon is into the end zone for the touchdown. So it's not a receiving touchdown, but one on the ground for one of the top talents in the National Arena League, Cameron Solomon. Gets the Sharks into the end zone on just two offensive plays, and he got the ball on both of them. It's 14-7. Nick Belcher ready for this PAT attempt. Another good snap by Wilson, and the kick is good. So Jacksonville, thanks to that kickoff out of bounds, now has an 8-point lead. It's 15-7. Sharks over the Predators. 5:36 to go in the first. We'll be back in a moment. You're watching Jacksonville Sharks football here on YouTube Live.
We're ready for battle for ourselves and for you. A season of excitement and fun with the Sharks is here. We're prepared. Now it's fins up in the Shark Tank, leaving it all on the field. And it's you, our fans, who give us the strength to fight for victory and our final goal. Your Jacksonville Sharks are back, and they're chasing a ship. Get your tickets today.
Locally owned and operated for over 60 years, Tom Neal is your number one source for heavy-duty trucks, parts, and service to get you and your load where you need to go. A certified dealer for Freightliner, Western Star, Volvo, and Isuzu, we know trucks. Stop by any of our Jacksonville, Lake City, or Waycross locations, or visit TomNeal.com.
Sharks fans, are you looking for something new to do at a Sharks game? Book a Sharks party deck. Enjoy a spacious party deck with great view on game day. Handpick one of our party deck food packages. If you like good food, fun, and football, try Sharks party deck at our next home game. Book your Sharks party deck today. Call David Gleason at 904-621-0700, extension 702, or email him at dave@jacksharks.com. Make sure to tell them the Attack sent you.
Thank you.
Back in the Shark Tank, I want to remind you, Metro Diner is your best local restaurant where you come for a hot cup of coffee, a warm welcome, and a full belly, where familiar comfort food dishes meet new bold obsessions, where you'll find a menu full of unique takes on classic Southern food and breakfast served all day. Visit Metro Diner today. 15-7 the score after the four-yard touchdown run by Cameron Solomon. This kickoff from Belcher will bounce off the net. And Prince takes it, heads toward the middle of the field, now heading to the left side outside the numbers toward the wall. There's a flag down, so this may be coming back as Darius Prince gets outside the 15-yard line, pending the penalty.
During the return, holding, returning team. Number two, penalized half the distance from the spot of the foul. After enforcement, first down.
Joshua Jenkins called for the hold, and so that will back the Predators up to the 6-yard line. Now the Predators are lined up and ready on first and 10. Deep drop from Southwick, and his throw is in a dangerous spot as it was nearly intercepted by Harrison Poole. Instead, bouncing off the wall and then ricocheting in front of Poole. I think Southwick was expecting his receiver to come back to the football. Prince headed up the field, and if that throw was a little bit more to the right, I think Poole might have had a touchdown of his own. Brandon Fuentes on the field in place of Lonnie Outlaw here on this drive as the Predators substitute. Second and 10, Southwick has Trevante Long. It's a 4-yard gain, tackle by Stoshak. Third and 6 coming up here for Orlando. Long thought he might have had some middle of the space or middle some space in the middle of the field. But Poole was there to force him back the other way, and Stoshak cleans up the tackle. Under 4 to play here in the first quarter. Already one stop for the Jacksonville defense. Now third down for Orlando. Southwick, his pass batted down at the line. And it's going to be 4th and 6. I think it might have been Justin Renfro who got his big paw on that one. We'll take a look at the replay here. Southwick goes to the left, and yeah, it is Renfro putting his right arm up, getting a piece of the football and knocking it down. Heads up play by the veteran defensive lineman here for Jacksonville. You got Renfro, David Gilbert, Shaquille Holiness, and Brandon Munoz coming out for the quarterback here on 4th and 6. Southwick. Back to pass, throws, has a man over the middle. It's Prince for a first down. He'll get out near midfield, finally taken down to the 24-yard line. Orlando averts potential disaster by converting a 4th and 6. The offensive line for the Predators held up just enough to give Southwick time to set his feet, throw a solid strike in the direction of Prince. And it's now 1st and 10, Orlando from their own 24-yard line. Long in motion, pitch goes to Nick Haig, the backup fullback, and he gets around the corner for about 4. Haig, a longtime Arena football veteran, spent a lot of time with the Spokane Shock back in the AFL days, now here in Orlando. Giving Desmond Maxwell a break, but if you're at fullback for Orlando, apparently you're going to get the ball tonight. Southwick deep to the right side for Fuentes, but it's incomplete. Jabari Gorman jumped up. I'm not sure if he got a hand on it, but it was enough to at least distract the receiver. Here's a look. Southwick lets it go, and yeah, Jabari Gorman did just get just enough. Actually ended up deflecting it pretty much toward Fuentes, but that change of direction must have tripped up the receiver. And now another third down and about five here for Orlando. Approaching the final minute of the first quarter, Prince in motion. Southwick under pressure, lets it go, and that one is going to be incomplete. Just skipped off the turf before Brandon Fuentes pulled it in. So for a second time on this drive, Orlando facing a fourth down. That was one of the first times the Sharks pass rush really, I think, made an impact on that one, because Southwick had to get rid of it kind of with his momentum going backwards. It didn't get enough on the throw to get it to his receiver in the air. We'll see what Jacksonville's defense can dial up here on fourth and a long four. Orlando needs the 16-yard line. Southwick under pressure, throws over the middle. It's intercepted. The second interception, this one Marvin Ross. Ross has some running room, 15, 20, 25, 20, 15, 10. Marvin Ross into the end zone for the second time in the first quarter. Jacksonville gets a pick six as Marvin Ross gets into business. And Jacksonville leads 21-7. The Sharks intercepted Orlando quarterbacks four times last week, and they picked up right where they left off. Here's a look at it. Southwick's throw. It just ends up going right to Ross, who spins out of one tackle, gets a couple of blocks downfield. You see Prince there had a chance, but couldn't pull him down. Stoshak threw a block, and then another block there by a defender. I think that might have been Wilson, and that was all Marvin Ross needed. Made one last man miss right at the end. As time has run out in the first quarter with all that action going on, but we will get the PAT before going to break. Stoshak puts the ball down. Belcher's kick is up and off the upright, so Belcher does not connect on his third PAT. But still, it's another score for Jacksonville at the end of the first quarter. The Sharks now lead 21-7. Although it looks like Shaquille Holiness went down right at the end or after that play. Not exactly sure what happened as I saw him go down, but we'll keep an eye on that as, again, it's the end of the first quarter, 21-7 the score.
Wade, this is the Dad Bod Edition. sexy boy. Love, love's going to
round one. Fight.
Your Attack Dance Team and the Dads, ladies and gentlemen. Show them some love.
Oh, you can do better than that. Show them brother some love.
Show them all some love.
We're in the heart of Springfield, that close to downtown in Jacksonville. You can either stop by. We're at 1501 North Main Street. We service the Jacksonville area. Our clients are people who are busy moms, busy dads, families, career-driven people who don't have the time to cook at home or who just like the convenience of someone prepping and cooking their meals. I put love into my food, and everyone says that they can taste the love. You can order online at readyprepgo.online. We are also on social media.
Back here in the Shark Tank, ready for the start of the second quarter. For over 45 years, Southern Furniture Leasing has provided quality rental furniture at competitive prices. They pride themselves on their customer service, amazing selection, and speed of delivery. Whether you need corporate, residential, or student housing furniture packages, the Southern Furniture Leasing team has the right selection and value you're looking for. Southern Furniture Leasing invites you to explore their wide selection of top quality furnishings. Belcher's kick is away. This one again off the net, and it briefly gets away from Prince, but he pulls it in and now tries to pick his way forward. He'll only get to about the 7-yard line. Trey Harlan again down in coverage. I think that's his second special teams tackle of the night, as that's where Orlando will take over. Now down by 14. D. Armstrong Contracting does everything from procurement of land, purchase or lease, to architects, engineers, general contractors, and subcontractors as well, as all other services necessary to build your next project. They specialize in small to mid-sized businesses looking to build and promise to save you as much as they can. It's Rakeem Cato now at quarterback for the Predators. I'm not sure if that was the plan or if that's an effect of the two pick sixes thrown by Danny Southwick, as Cato's first pass is going to be incomplete, but they're going to flag Marvin Ross for some contact as Prince ended up on the ground.
Pass interference, defense, number one.
And they're going to call it pass interference against Jacksonville.
Automatic first down.
Ross doesn't appear to be thrilled about that call, but not a particularly long penalty since the flag came in well before the end point of that pass. First and 10, handoff goes to Maxwell. He'll fight his way forward out across the 20-yard line. Another pick of about six for Desmond Maxwell. He's been a pretty sure thing on the ground so far tonight. Already one touchdown. About six or seven carries for Maxwell here in this contest. Rakeem Cato at quarterback. Played collegiately at Marshall, started this season with the Fayetteville Mustangs. Has now come down to Orlando, hands it off to Maxwell again. And for a moment, I thought he might have lost the football, but he does keep it in his right hand and gets first down yardage. Another drive where the Predators go with back-to-back runs and pick up 11 or 12 yards. And now Maxwell held on to that cleanly, a little bit dangerous just with the ball out there in the open in that right hand. Cato spent a lot of time here with the Orlando Predators last season, his first in the NAL. And now back, they'll pitch it to Maxwell, and another pickup for the Predators on the ground, 5 or 6 yards. It's hard to call it ball control offense when the clock is going to run regardless, but Orlando certainly content to get 5 or 6 yards at a time. It's the second time already in this first half they've gone with 3 consecutive running plays. So one way to keep the pass rush in check is make the defensive lineman pause for a half second to make sure you're not running the football. They will throw this time, though. Cato pump fakes, now rolls to the left, and he'll just throw it away. Flag is down in the offensive backfield in the area of a hold. We'll get the call here from Aaron West momentarily. It is does appear to be against Orlando since they're over there talking to Bill Alford.
Holding, offense, number 91. 10-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Brandon Cisse flagged for the hold. Just trying to keep Russell away from his quarterback and definitely seemed to grab a bit of jersey there. Early stage of the second quarter. Cato deep drop, throws left, has long. They get most of the penalty yardage back. It'll bring up about a 3rd and 5 after the 10-yard completion. First down yardage now for the Predators as Trey Long hauls it in right in front of the sticks. Jensen Stoshak on the tackle to make sure there was nothing after the catch, but on 3rd and 4, they got 5. And now the Predators have 1st and goal right at the 10-yard line. Trey Long, a guy who also started the season with Fayetteville, has that connection with Rakeem Cato. They'll go on the ground again. Maxwell, 3 yards. Continuing to keep the Sharks pass rush honest with the use of the running game. So at the end of the first quarter, to come back to this, at the end of the PAT, Shaquille Holiness must have got rolled up on or something happened. He went down and was eventually carried off the field by a couple of his teammates, not walking at all, let alone putting any weight on wherever the issue is. So not a great immediate sign. Again, not entirely sure what happened there. We'll see if Holiness is able to come back in later on. But for now, it's Price and Russell at the defensive end spots. Flag is down. Cato drifting his pass in front of Long, incomplete. Long wants a flag. He won't get one.
Illegal defensive alignment. Defense, number 77. Penalized half the distance.
But they'll get Russell for illegal formation. Whatever. And that's going to give the Predators an automatic first down. Coach Alford certainly wants an explanation for that one. This drive has used up the first 5 minutes of the second quarter and counting. It's now 1st and goal from the 4-yard line for Orlando. Jarvis coming up, Jacksonville, let's go. They'll pitch it to Maxwell. Nothing doing this time. He does spin forward after the hit for a yard. But Jeremiah Price there on the hit. And it's third down, so they're going to say that the illegal formation was not an automatic first down. The way that the call was made as illegal defense typically does result in an automatic first down, but if it's a formation infraction, it's not. And so it's third and two here for Orlando. 5 seconds on the play clock. Prince in motion. Cato out of the gun. And he won't get there. Trey Harlan stacks up the quarterback and drops him for no gain.
Meet my friend, Mr. Trey Harlan.
Harlan has been all over the field making tackles on special teams. Now on defense from his nose spot. You can see there he sheds the block of Freddie Booth and takes down the quarterback, Cato. Been a 6.5 minute drive for Orlando, coming down to fourth and goal from the two. Cato out of the gun, runs right, and he won't get there. He gets hit into the boards at the 1 yard line. Jacksonville with another stop, and the Sharks will take over on downs. Cato with a quarterback sweep to the short side. Devin Wilson with the stop. Jacksonville leads 21-7 and is set to go back on offense. We'll be back in just a moment here on YouTube Live.
You can book an event or give Dave a call at 904-621-0700, extension 702, or email dave@jacksharks.com. Remember, we create memories, and your event will never get delayed or rained out.
Real estate title work and title insurance is often viewed as a boring and tedious part of a real estate closing on a property. Our business tagline? Focused, fun, deals done. We take what we do very seriously, but derive satisfaction from making the closing process a positive and worry-free experience for both the buyer and the seller. So if you're looking to close on a property, come to Titletown, and we'll show you around.
Hey Shark Nation, it's your ticket guy, David Diana. If you're a local business owner, we want to turn our fans into your newest customers. I have an offer. Jorah's partnerships are a great way to get your company name and information in front of all our fans in the Shark Tank. We are also going to reward you with a year-round digital advertising on our website and provide you with a promotional table for your business at each Sharks game. Plus, you'll receive season tickets for your business to provide to your family, staff, and even potential clients. If you want to become a Jorah's partner this season, I can hook you up. Just call me. 904-621-0700, extension 717, or you can go online at jacksharks.com and fill out.
And we're back here in the Shark Tank. First drive of the second quarter for Sam Castronova and the Jacksonville offense, already with a 14-point lead, getting the ball back thanks to a third defensive stop. Quick pass on first down to Devin Wilson, who gets tackled along the wall for a second. Thought he might have shed that and continued up the field, but it's a gain of about 3 yards. A little bit of breathing room for the offense after that turnover on down. Started this drive at about the 1.5 yard line. Starting receivers, Stoshak, Solomon, and Devin Wilson, the motion man, here in the game, and Wilson gets it, and he'll have first down yardage, fighting for more out near the 15-yard line goes Devin Wilson. Fans, meet United Real Estate, the modern alternative to old-school real estate brokerages. In 2011, we set out with a grand plan to change how traditional real estate brokerages operate, and we are succeeding. The formula for success is consistently exceeding clients' expectations. From coast to coast, agents stand ready to assist you with selling, buying, or relocation. Come explore United. Two straight completions to Devin Wilson has the Sharks with a new set of downs from their own 14-yard line. Castronova, deeper drop, looking for Stoshak. He's got him. It's a Jacksonville incompletion as Jensen Stoshak ran into the wall. The door opened up, and that might have dislodged the football. Castronova had running room, but he was looking for Stoshak all the way. Stoshak all alone deep down the field. It was a perfect pass. The receiver was there. And, yeah, when the door came open, you could see Stoshak not happy about that, banging the door in frustration. I think just that loss of tension from the door opening messed up his timing, and he ends up dropping the football. So now second and 10, Wilson in motion. Castronova under pressure, and he will go down. Sam Castronova in the grasp, never actually hits the turf, but does get sacked. Richard McKenzie, the first one in for Orlando there. As that pocket collapsed, and Castronova, who was drifting left, maybe looking for some running room, couldn't find any. The first bit of adversity here for the Jacksonville offense that only ran two plays in the first quarter. That's what happens when you have back-to-back pick sixes. Now third and long after the sack. Castronova throws and has a man along the wall. It's Solomon. He makes the catch. It's not a first down, but it's a good pickup. Gain of about 8 on third and 14, and it's now fourth and 6 coming up for Jacksonville. Make that 4th and 4 after a gain of 10. The Sharks need their own 24-yard line to extend this drive. 5 minutes to play in the second quarter. Wilson, the motion man. Castronova, deep drop, looks right. Has Solomon, first down yardage, and Cameron Solomon converts. Eventually pushed along the wall right about where he caught it. But it's a gain of about 10, and Jacksonville moves the chains and keeps this drive going. A safe throw there from Castronova to Solomon. The Jacksonville quarterback comes back from that sack with two straight completions to number 6. And now the Sharks have it at Orlando's 21-yard line. Castronova to Munoz. The fullback is wide open to the 10. Munoz inside the 5-yard line. They released the fullback. He found some open space. Eventually tackled by Haig, but it's a gain of 14. You see there, and it was Haig who Munoz got away from originally. On probably 95% of pass attempts, the fullback is in to protect, which is why he can throw the defense off when he does go out for a route. That's what happened there. It's now first and goal from the 5-yard line. Castronova will take it himself, slips one tackle, and another diving forward. I don't think he got in, but he got close. Castronova putting his arms in the air as if he did get a touchdown. I don't think they're going to give it to him, though. And it's second and goal from the 1-yard line. A quick look there at Jason Gibson, the head coach who has Jacksonville at this 8-2 record. The only two losses by a point each. Gibson, of course, a longtime head man in Columbus, Georgia for the Lions, trading the Columbus blue for the Jacksonville red, black, and white. And now second and goal from the 1-yard line for Castronova and the offense. Castronova hands it off to Munoz. I think the ball might have come out. But Munoz still has it. And it's third and goal. Some Predators are motioning like they want the challenge flag to come out. I don't think the Orlando coaching staff is going to oblige. Two minutes to play here in the second quarter when this one gets snapped. Wilson in motion. Castronova takes it himself around the left side, and he will fight his way in for a touchdown. Sam Castronova with his quickness on display. It's his first rushing touchdown of the night, and Jacksonville now leads by 20. It's 27-7. Munoz with a block on Outlaw and got in the way of Fuentes as well. Effective job there by the fullback to go outside. That cleared some space in his wake, and Castronova darted in for six. Now he'll do the holding with Belcher on, and Belcher's kick up and good. So Jacksonville now leads by three scores. It's 28-7. 1:35 to go in the second quarter. We'll step aside. Back in a moment here on YouTube Live.
Hello, we're Christopher and Carla Rockefort, and welcome to Evolution Signs and Print. We're a family-owned and operated business with over 30 years of experience in the printing industry, and we're proud to call Jacksonville our home. We specialize in custom fleet wraps, marketing materials, signage, and wide format media. We handle our clients' projects from design to delivery and installation. There is no job too big, too small, too simple, or too challenging.
The Sharks want to invite you to our last regular season home game, Saturday, July 22nd.
It's Military Appreciation Night, as the Sharks take on the West Texas Warbirds in the ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena.
Enjoy a great game and then meet me, my teammates, and the attack on the field for our post-game autograph session, sponsored by Showtime Sports, Cards, and Collective.
For tickets, give our ticket team a call, 904-621-0700, or visit jacksharks.com.
Wow, did you see that play? Fuel the feeding frenzy with Dick's Wings and Grill. Mouth-watering wings, tenders, and Dick's famous waffle fries. And to make waves outside the arena, visit dickswingsandgrill.com for the best wings, burgers, wraps, and ice-cold craft beer. First bite to last call, there's something for everyone. Fuel up where the Sharks feed at Dick's Wings and Grill.
To receive a free seat upgrade. Congratulations to tonight's lucky family. Join the sweet life. Thanks to Dick's Wings.
Nick Melcher on again, nearly his friends factor. 28-7 Jacksonville all over Orlando so far here in this first half. Remember, the Sharks won the toss, deferred, and then we'll be back to receive the opening kickoff of the third quarter when we get there. Still a lot to happen in these final 95 seconds as Belgium will go onside, and this one's going to bounce into the stands. Jacksonville had that one set up well. Unfortunately for the Sharks, that one bounced a bit too short. Has to go to the 10 before you can touch it. Officials discussing things here.
Big 65 is real mad. What you mad about, bro? Did you pray
There are two fouls on this play, both on the kicking team. Offside, kicking team, number 22. That penalty is declined. Illegal kick out of bounds, kicking team, number 20. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. 1 point awarded to Orlando. First down, Orlando.
So with that ball going out of bounds at the 8, Jacksonville, of course, didn't have an opportunity to try and recover it. And it's 1 point for the Predators, so now 28-8 is the score. And Orlando's got an opportunity to try and get into the end zone. I think the thought here is if you're Coach Gibson, if they're going to score, do it quickly so that you could potentially get the ball back with all three of your timeouts and a chance to run your offense in the final minute. See how Orlando plays this. Southwick back to pass. He throws that one incomplete. Notable that it is Southwick back in the game here on this drive. So that one incomplete, and I think this is going to bring the 1 minute timeout as the clock will stop there.
1 minute timing rules are now in effect. Jacksonville and Orlando have all three timeouts. Each team may challenge. By rule, all timeouts will be a 30-second timeout. This will be an opportunity for a media timeout.
So we'll step aside as well. 1 minute left in the first half. We'll be back in a moment. 28-8 the score here on YouTube Live.
It's just a great opportunity to meet some of the community members as well as to get some of the stories from the players, because come to find out, one of the players is a former student of Darnell Cookman. So for our students to hear that somebody from Darnell Cookman has made it to the next level was just awe-inspiring. And I know that can be said with a lot of schools as their students matriculate through the system and move on to bigger and better things. But I say this has been a great, wonderful partnership to hear the stories, to hear how they're engaging the community, to hear how they're supporting education is just fabulous. So I would recommend this to any of my peers and colleagues out there in DCPS to reach out to the Sharks or contact me and I'll give you the information to build some partnerships and lasting relationships.
Welcome to Jacksonville, or as we like to call it, Jax. As Florida's youngest city, Jacksonville is the destination that you'll leave feeling refreshed. Here, you'll experience a different kind of Florida, one that's rich with arts, culture, and history, exciting outdoor adventures, thrilling sporting events, and a mouth-watering dining scene, all at a more laid-back pace. If you love the outdoors, you've come to the right place. Head to visitjacksonville.com to learn more.
Final minute of the first half coming up. Florida Blue is more than an insurer. They're your health partner, working to lower your costs, make your benefits easy to access, and providing you with a broad range of health services that include traditional medical care, mental well-being, preventative care, and so much more. Visit a Jacksonville Florida Blue Center to receive a complimentary Jacksonville Sharks gift. So it's second and goal from the 7-yard line for Orlando. Worth noting for Jacksonville, Shaquie Holiness, who was essentially carried off the field at the end of the first quarter after going down following a PAT, is back on the field. So good to see Holiness, the sack leader for Jacksonville with 10 this season, back on the field wearing number 95, joining David Gilbert, Justin Renfro, and Anthony Johnson in that front four for Jacksonville here on this possession. Second down snap taken by Southwick. Looks toward the corner, actually more in the middle, and has Outlaw for a touchdown. So Orlando converts, but Jacksonville will have about 45 seconds after the kickoff. So it's 28-14, the 7-yard touchdown from Southwick to Outlaw.
Get ready.
Just the second point after attempt of the game for Dylan Barnes, 1-for-1 so far. And that one's blocked by Johnson, and here comes Holiness trying to chase it down, and Fuentes won't pick it up. Harrison Poole gets it. Poole tries to keep his feet, but won't get in there. Jacksonville about 5 yards away from 2 points. But the ball kind of bounced around just too much for Harrison Poole to pick it up cleanly. Anthony Johnson on the block. Just completely shedding the block. And so it's 28-14, 38 seconds left here in the first half. Gives us a chance to tell you that you can discover the South Bank Hotel at Jacksonville Riverwalk, a downtown hotel drawing inspiration from the St. John's River ports and area bridges, providing an authentic Northeast Florida experience. This centrally located hotel is nestled on the South Bank of downtown Jacksonville near the trendy San Marco and Riverside historic districts. Experience the coastal undercurrents and feel the hospitality when you stay at the South Bank Hotel at Jacksonville Riverwalk. We have not yet seen the Orlando Predators kick deep tonight. Only their second kickoff coming up. The first one was an onside attempt that was a high hop that sailed out of bounds. So it's essentially even. Each team has had an onside kick bounce over the wall, giving a point to the other team, and each team has had an extra point no good. So we're all square on that front, and it's 28-14, a regular 14-point margin. Jacksonville once again will have 7 players up close to the line.
Kindly reset the game clock to 51 seconds. There are 51 seconds left in the second quarter.
They're going to reset the clock to 51 seconds. I think they ran it on that point after attempt.
Thank you.
When in reality, in the final minute, it should be a stopped clock, and that benefits the Jacksonville offense. The Sharks have 51 seconds, a little bit less after this kickoff, and all 3 timeouts to work with. Barnes will send this one away. It's a high kick off the net, fielded by Solomon, a slow start, and he'll only get to about the 6-yard line. Jonathan McAllister on the stop. The one downside of preventing the onside kick with an extra man up by the line is you lose out on a blocker close to your returner. And so McAllister able to charge down the field, make that tackle. It only took 4 seconds. So here comes Coach Gibson, Sam Castronova, and the Shark offense. All 3 timeouts, 47 seconds to work with. So you got to keep an eye on the clock, but you can essentially run your regular offense at this point if you're Jacksonville and try and work your way down the field in some chunks and score as close to the end of the half as possible. Castronova's first pass of the drive is complete. That one along the left side to Devin Wilson out near the 20-yard line. First down, Jacksonville. Now 40 seconds left with that one going toward the wall. Jacksonville does not have to use a timeout. So it's Stoshak, Wilson, and Solomon. The 3 receivers seeing most of the action for Jacksonville here tonight. Solomon swings around wide in motion, 1st and 10. And that one complete to Devin Wilson along the left side. He'll again put the ball over the wall. It only uses about 3 seconds. An ideal start to the drive if you're Jacksonville's offense. 2 plays, 2 first downs. And now they're inside the 20-yard line, 1st and 10 from the 19. The Sharks trying to make this once again a 3-touchdown game at the end of the half. Castronova has Johnson with some running room. Anthony Johnson at the five toward the corner, waiting for a signal. And it's a touchdown for Jacksonville as Johnson gets in. Anthony Johnson, the fullback, releases. Castronova hits him. Touchdown number 38 for Sam Castronova as a quarterback. Johnson will go into the stands to celebrate, hand delivering the football. And it's 34-14 Jacksonville. Second time in this quarter, the Jacksonville's released the fullback. Johnson this time gets set free and into the end zone for the touchdown. Got some contact but did not go into the wall until he was across the goal line. Belcher's kick is no good. Bouncing off the right upright. And that's a dead ball. So 34-14 is the margin. 30 seconds left here in the second quarter. A bit of a slow start to this game. Although if you're Jacksonville's defense, it was anything but, with two pick sixes. But not a whole lot of offense in the first quarter. But this second quarter started to open up a little bit. The Sharks with a couple of touchdown drives. Orlando a short scoring drive of their own. And the NAL's top scoring team is right on pace. They average about 64 points a game coming in. They've scored 34 here in this first half. And for the second straight week, have opened up a pretty sizable margin on the Predators in the first half. It was a big second quarter last week where Jacksonville outscored Orlando 33-7 in the second quarter to lead 46-15 at halftime. Now, it's not quite that big of a margin yet, and it was really the first quarter in which Jacksonville set the tone with those two interception returns for touchdowns, one by Jabari Gorman, one by Marvin Ross. Last week it was 53-15 at the end of three, and then Orlando piled up some points when the game was pretty much out of hand to make the margin 23. This is the rubber match between these two teams this season. The Predators, the only team to, or the last team, I should say, to beat Jacksonville, 61-60 here in the tank a couple of weeks ago. As Orlando trying to figure something out with substitutions, and I think they're going to have to call timeout. They will. So Orlando timeout. Spends a 30-second timeout.
This is their first charge timeout of the half. This is a 30-second timeout.
They've expanded the substitution settings, if you will, here in the NAL this season with additional specialists and some clarification on the rules of, you know, who can re-enter the game if you've come in and then left in a quarter. And I think that's part of what the issue is there, is Orlando's trying to figure out who all should be on the field. As they still have nine guys on the field trying to figure out who should come off. Now they send Gerard Cook to the bench. And so I think they have the correct eight on the turf. The Predators certainly expecting Jacksonville to kick it deep here. With only 30 seconds left, that's who we'd expect. Belcher sends it away, and this one headed toward the net. And it's going to be off the bar, fielded by the up-back Long. He'll cut all the way back now around to the left side and taken down by Gorman inside the five-yard line. Great pursuit by Jabari Gorman to take down Long. And with the way that that play got extended, it uses 6 seconds. Orlando only has 24 ticks to work with. You can see Long here just trying to make something happen, but Gorman able to catch up to him and makes a stop. For Jacksonville, the mission is hold off Orlando here because you know you're going to be back to receive the opening kickoff of the third quarter. The Predators need to get down the field in a hurry with only two timeouts. Rakeem Cato.
Uh-oh. Somebody made a mistake.
It's actually Darius Prince, it looked like, at quarterback.
Offside. High motion man. Penalized half the distance.
And Orlando a little bit off with the timing there. High motion man offside. They're backed up half the distance. So the Predators are going to Darius Prince, it appears, at quarterback right now. And I don't know if that's because of a substitution with the quarterbacks, but Prince is in a very deep shotgun here. He'll take the snap and fire it deep downfield. It's up and incomplete. Trey Long, the intended receiver, Stoshak there in coverage. We saw this a couple of games ago where Fayetteville and one of the players actually was Rakeem Cato, who had been substituted in and out and ended up becoming ineligible for the rest of the half. If that's happened here, that would explain why Prince has to be the quarterback. The Predators have used both Southwick and Cato here in this quarter. And Prince fakes the handoff, and he's trying to escape. He won't. It's a safety. Jacksonville takes down Prince in the end zone. I think it's Jeremiah Price. Russell there as well. The Sharks get 2 points. Brian Smith there on the stop as well for Jacksonville. It's 36-14. We'll take a look. They fake the handoff to McAllister, and Smith just had nowhere to go. I think Russell was in there first. Smith eventually the one to take him down. Trey Harlan actually made the first hit. Everybody all over the field for the Sharks. And it's 22-point lead, 36-14.
By rule, following a safety, a 2-point deuce cannot be scored by the kicking team. Of course.
And now we know that no way is half the bet. What's up about G.I. Joe fans?
So the clarification made by Aaron West, because there's a safety, you don't give the kicker an opportunity to make up those 2 points. So even if Barnes were to put this through the uprights, it would not be 2 points for Jacksonville. Now all of a sudden, you went from just getting the stop to end the half to actually having a chance to go for another touchdown. The Sharks are going to get the ball, you would assume. It's 36-14 after the safety. Solomon and Stoshak back deep for Jacksonville. Barnes with a low chip kick, fielded by Smith. He'll now try the right side, getting a block. Smith in the 15, down near the 10-yard line. Good heads-up play by Brian Smith as they tried to kick it into some empty space between the front line and the up-back, but Smith, who's a receiver and linebacker by trade, with enough athleticism to get back there, fielded and pick up about 12 yards on the return. Maybe needed one more block to fully get loose, but either way, Jacksonville's got a chance to run at least one, possibly two plays here from the 10-yard line.
Timeout, Jacksonville. This is their first charge timeout of the half. This is a 30-second timeout.
And having not used the timeout yet, Coach Gibson will take that opportunity, make sure they have the right play call. I think he might have wanted to take a look at how the Predators would line up and then reassess the play call.
Timeout.
Only one touchdown pass tonight so far for Castronova, which seems strange given the score, but with two interception touchdowns and two rushing touchdowns, that'll happen. And Castronova gets taken down. There is a second left. The Sharks will call timeout. Orlando with a second sack tonight.
Timeout. Jacksonville. This is their second charge timeout of the half. This is a 30-second timeout.
So just 1 second left. Barring a defensive penalty, this will be the final play of the first half incoming. If you're Jacksonville, this would really just be a bonus. You're already up by 22 points. You're going to get the ball or at least be back to receive the opening kickoff of the third quarter. If you can score here, then that really puts things in your favor. But either way, you're happy with this first half. It'll be Devin Wilson, the motion man, here with 1 second left in the first half. Castronova takes the snap. Back to pass, drifts left in the pocket, now steps up, and he fumbles the football. It's picked up by Trey Harland, who's going to try and make something happen, but eventually will get tackled, and the ball comes free. And after the second fumble, that's how the first half will end. So Jacksonville...
Minute, the fourth down fumble rule applies. When number 11 recovered the ball, it became dead. That's the end of the first half.
So we've hit the end of the first half. It's 36-14. Jacksonville with two pick sixes, some solid offense, a defensive stop as well on a fourth down, and a 22-point edge. I believe we're expecting to hear from Marvin Ross here momentarily as they get that set up. But if you're Jacksonville winning six in a row,
Marvin, it is fourth down Orlando. You know you have to make a big play, and you get a first interception at home. Walk me through what you saw on the field.
I just seen that with fourth down, I knew they were going to go to the sticks. All my teammates did what they had to do, and we just made it happen.
We are leading by 22 points going into the half. As one of the team captains, what is your message to your teammates in the locker room?
It's 0-0 still. We can't be complacent. Still come out, have our foot on their neck, and just go and win the game.
Thanks, Marvin.
All right, fans up.
Thank you.
36-14 at halftime. We'll step aside, take a break for a few minutes. We'll be back to chat you through that first half here from the Tank. Back in a moment here on YouTube Live.
Are you being fairly compensated for your service-connected disabilities?
If you answered yes, then trust the veterans at True Vet Solutions to get you the compensation you deserve.
Call today for a free, no-obligation consultation. You have nothing to lose and a lifetime of benefits to gain.
Ever thought about why we take trips? They take time off, time to plan, time to pack. They take work. They give us a chance to reconnect with ourselves, our family, and our friends, and maybe even a new one. And when they're over, all we're left with are the memories. Memories that inspire stories, and stories that become legacies. So no matter where your next trip takes you, come home with a story. General RV.
Magnificent. I mean, I'm at a loss of words. This was, having prior conversations and going through the logistics prior to this event, I was like, this is going to be nice. But to see what they brought to the table, the Sharks, to see how open and welcoming and warm they were to my students, I have nothing but glowing reviews for what they've done and what they're going to continue to do. So to say that they're a part of the community is an understatement. They are a true partnership in education and learning for Duval County and Duval County Public School students.
Want to know PDQ's secret sauce? It's better chicken. Fresh premium tenderloins. Always made to order, and it's fast. With an open kitchen, you can see exactly how your food is made. PDQ, just made better.
Back here at the Shark Tank, 36-14. Let's quickly take you through how the first half unfolded. Jabari Gorman got the scoring started, a 45-yard pick six on the first drive of the game. Then after the teams traded rushing touchdowns, it was Marvin Ross, another pick six for Jacksonville. That made it 21-7 at the end of the first quarter. Opening the second, a long drive for Orlando ended up with no points as Devin Wilson made the tackle on Rakeem Cato to force a turnover on downs. It was a Castronova touchdown run to put the Sharks up by 21. Lonnie Outlaw brought the Predators back within 14 points, but then Anthony Johnson, an 18-yarder from Castronova, made it 34-14. Then Jacksonville gets the safety just before halftime to get this 36-14 margin. Sam Castronova, 9 of 10 passing in that first half with 105 yards and a touchdown. And Cameron Solomon and Castronova with rushing touchdowns for Jacksonville. So the Sharks have played efficiently on offense. Some big plays on defense. That's how they lead by 22 points. Let's take another break, and we'll be back with just a minute or so to go before the start of the third quarter here in a fast-moving halftime. Again, 36-14. We'll be back in a minute here on YouTube Live.
At Premier Medical Spa, we combine the comfort and courtesy of aesthetics with the necessities of modern medical dermatology. We offer a wide range of advanced treatments designed to provide results to improve wellness, from radiofrequency skin tightening to IV vitamin infusions and facials. Give us a call today for a free consultation, 904 855-0605.
Are you waking up in the morning with a sore jaw, headaches, maybe even ringing in your ears, all because you're grinding and clenching your teeth at night? That's exactly what was going on with me. That's when I found this, the Brux Night Guard. Now, the Brux Night Guard redirects the bite force away from the back teeth, reducing jaw pain while still protecting the teeth. This unique design is what makes Brux Night Guard different from all other traditional grind guards. Go to bruxnightguard.com and order yours today.
My name is Caroline Salvador. I teach English language arts here at Darnell Cookman School of the Medical Arts, and it is for sixth grade. My favorite part about today's presentation was seeing the authenticity. When the speakers say, you know, I actually did struggle in school, and that was actually an obstacle to get over. That's something that a lot of my sixth graders can relate to, as they're kind of expected to come to this school and, you know, accelerate, and they do struggle with that transition. I think that that message will certainly resonate, along with her messages about her daughter and patience, something that I could certainly use more as a teacher. Based upon today's presentation, I would certainly emphasize how hands-on the Jacksonville Sharks have been, especially in the Duval County School System community. Working around in schools like Andrew Jackson, and here I've noticed the presence of Jacksonville Sharks, and y'all have just been tremendous mentors at middle school level and high school. So that's really my takeaway, and that's something that I would just continue to promote about you all, even though I don't know much about sports.
Imagine a knife taking this much abuse and didn't need sharpening. Introducing the incredible NutriBlade knives, coated with granite stone nonstick and made of stainless steel, one of the hardest substances on earth. Now everyone can chop, slice, and dice just like a pro. Order right now to get this professional six-piece set of NutriBlades for just $29.95. We'll even ship them to you free. Get your own NutriBlade knives, the last knives you'll ever buy.
Just about a minute or so before the start of the second half, the Sharks and a Predator player starting to make their way back on the field to get loose again. 36-14 is the score. Xander Keene bringing you all the action here from the Shark Tank tonight. This is week 15 of the National Arena League season, the third to last week of the regular year. Jacksonville 8-2 trying to maintain first place in the National Arena League standings. A pivotal game right now between the number 2 and number 3 seeds in the NAL going on up in Greensboro. Right now it's 25-21 in favor of the homestanding Carolina Cobras as they face the San Antonio Gunslingers. Carolina currently 7-4. A game and a half, two losses behind San Antonio and Jacksonville. Worth noting, because just with the way the schedule has worked out this year, it's going to be an uneven number of games. Carolina has already played 11. They will end up playing 14 games. They're active in all 3 weeks remaining here in the season. The Sharks will play 10, and they will end up with 13 games played. San Antonio's played 10, but they do not have a game the final week of the season. Again, with five teams playing right now, there's always one bye team. And so the Gunslingers will only get 12 games, and we'll see how that impacts the winning percentages. Either way, though, if this result holds, Jacksonville would be a game clear of San Antonio, with the Gunslingers only having a game left to play. I think that would just mean that the Sharks would have to win one of their last two to clinch first place. But a long way before we get there. Either way, if you're Jacksonville, you're just trying to handle your business, already up by 22 points, trying to improve to 9-2. Here's a look at, you saw there, Jabari Gorman's pick six. Anthony Johnson, the blocked PAT, the celebration after the safety. Cameron Solomon got the scoring started for the offense. Devin Wilson, his second game at home as the Sharks open it up on the Predators in the first half for the second straight week. And here's that Marvin Ross pick six, spinning away from Darius Prince. Gets a block from Stoshak, another block, as he made his way down the field and into the end zone for the second pick six of the first quarter. And here's Anthony Johnson's touchdown reception as the Sharks fullback gets in. The Predators have technically used three quarterbacks tonight. Danny Southwick got the start. He had those two interceptions in the first quarter. Rakeem Cato came in for a series, led the Predators down the field, but was tackled short of the goal line on a fourth down rushing attempt. Then Southwick came back in, and I think because of substitutions, they were forced to use Darius Prince on that final drive. As we're back underway, this kickoff goes deep off the net and drops into the stands. So with those rounded end zones, the deflection off the net did not end up in the field of play, so that's a touchback. And Jacksonville will start this drive. They'll put it at the 10. That's where Castronova and the Shark offense takes over here in the second half. Second to last regular season home game for the Sharks. We'll be back here this time next week as the West Texas Warbirds make their trip to the Shark Tank. The Sharks trying to handle business here in the last 30 minutes. First and 10, deep drop. Castronova has a man down the sideline. And that is Devin Wilson at the 15. Wilson down near the 10-yard line, eventually tackled by Nick Haig, but not before a big gainer, an emphatic fist pump, as Devin Wilson, his biggest game since returning to the Sharks, led the team in receptions in the first half, gets the second half started off the right way with that catch and about 10 or 11 yards after the catch before finally getting taken down by Nick Haig. They'll put the ball at the 11, so it's not first and goal, but first and 10 for the Sharks, just outside the Predators' 10-yard line. Castronova flips it. It's Russell. Russell headed to the end zone. He's in. It's a Jacksonville touchdown. The shovel pass to the tight end. Russell takes it in, and Jacksonville leads 42-14. It's the second touchdown pass of the game for Sam Castronova, and neither one has gone to a wide receiver. Look at that flip. You get the blocker out front, Jabril G. Russell does the rest himself. And it's now a 28-point lead for Jacksonville with the PAT still to come. Belcher's kick up and good. A perfect start to the second half here for Jacksonville. It's 43-14. Jacksonville 43, Orlando 14. 13-12 to go here in the third quarter.
Awards including the Navy Unit Commendation Ribbon with two bronze stars, the Navy Victorious Unit Commendation with Marine Corps Expeditionary Medal, Southwest Asia Service Medal with two bronze stars, and Humanitarian Service Medal with one bronze star. He's a Shark season ticket holder who does not miss a game as well as put together goodie bags for our players during away travel.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's USA Hey hometown here of the game. United States Marine Corps Staff Sergeant Richard Judge.
All right, all right, all right. I need y'all to get loud for me. Time for the Beavers in T-shirt toss. Where I got section 100 competing against the military section. So I want to hear who can say it the loudest. Duval. 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 Hey, I am a proud service member. However, it's going to Section 100.
The ball teed up, ready to send this one away. Bit of a sidewinding kick off the net, fielded by Prince. Heads up the middle between the hashbacks, now toward the left side. Completely stops, juking his way, trying to find some room, and eventually just gives himself up into the wall at about the 15-yard line, where Orlando will take over. For over 45 years, Southern Furniture Leasing has provided quality rental furniture at competitive prices. They pride themselves on their customer service, amazing selection, and speed of delivery. Whether you need corporate, residential, or student housing furniture packages, the Southern Furniture Leasing team has the right selection and value you're looking for. Southern Furniture Leasing invites you to explore their wide selection of top quality furnishings. Danny Southwick back in at quarterback to open the third quarter here for the Predators. They'll send Prince in motion on first down. Southwick, left side, complete there. That one hauled in by Trey Long, who gets right out to midfield. It's going to be a gain of 11 and a first down. Poole on the tackle for Jacksonville.
Prior to the start of that series, number 13 became an offensive specialist.
Four defensive stops in the first half for Jacksonville, including two pick sixes and a safety. Trying to find some of that magic again, although McAllister.
Personal foul, roughing the passer.
And that defense, one is going to be some 44. Extra yardage. So McAllister with
the run.
The nice tight end release for some solid yardage. And then they're going to get David Gilbert for roughing the passer. That'll bring Orlando even closer as the Predators suddenly in just about goal-to-go yardage. They pulled the ball to the 7-yard line. Long in motion for Southwick. Steps back, throws to the right. That one caught there by Prince. I think Ross tried to jump the route for Jacksonville. It's actually Gorman jumping the route, trying to get his second pick six in about the same fashion, but not quite quick enough that time. 3-yard gain for Prince, and now second and goal. He'll pitch it to Maxwell. Cuts back to the right, trying to find the goal line, and he is in for a touchdown. The second one of the day for Desmond Maxwell, who got 11 carries in the first half. Rare you see that in arena football, but a second touchdown. So Maxwell from 3 yards out. Now a 43-20 margin with Barnes on for the PAT. And Barnes kick up and good. So now 43-21 is the score. 10-19 to go in the third quarter. We'll be back in a moment. You're watching Jacksonville Sharks football here on YouTube Live.
Lagasse here, and I'm so excited to tell you about my French Door Air Fryer 360. Extra large 26-quart capacity. Cook with up to 70% less calories from fat than deep frying. That's a big deal, my friend. 360 degrees of superheated air gives you fast, even cooking. My 10-in-1 French Door Air Fryer 360 grills, air fries, dehydrates, roasts, bakes, broils, proofs, slow cooks, and toasts. This baby does it all.
These French doors are a game changer. Look at how easy that is.
Now find out how you can try Emeril Lagasse's French Door Air Fryer 360 with three cooking tiers, fetch tool, air frying rack, and drip tray in your home for 30 days for just $14.99. Order now and you'll also get Emeril's Air Fryer Favorites recipe book. And we'll automatically upgrade you to our bonus cooking kit free. Plus, find out how you can get free shipping. This offer will not last, so call or click now to order.
You're going to love it. I guarantee it.
High five your favorite players as the Sharks prepare to take the field for battle. Enjoy a catered pre-game all-you-can-eat buffet in our private Duval room, perfect for networking and entertaining. Then, just before kickoff, you'll head into the tunnel outside the Sharks locker room to greet the players as they head out for pre-game introductions.
We're back here on the Shark Tank. USAA is proudly celebrating 100 years of serving the military community. Since 1922, USAA has grown from a group of soldiers who joined together to insure each other's vehicles because no other companies would, to more than 13 million members strong. And through it all, one thing has remained. USAA is still serving the military and their families. Find out more at USAA.com. Barnes sends this kick away, headed toward the uprights, and the deuce is good. So Barnes connects. That'll get Orlando within 20. Dylan Barnes getting it done with his left foot. If you're just tuning into NAL football for the first time and you're wondering what happened, well, ever since the Liz League was formed in 2017, one of the signature rules has been the deuce. 2 points if you kick it through the uprights on the kickoff in the air. It's also 1 point if the kickoff returner doesn't make it out of the end zone with the football. That's much rarer, but you do often see a deuce over the course of a game. Castronova's first pass going deep for Poole and has him. Harrison Poole in stride. It's a one-play touchdown for Jacksonville. Sam Castronova, 40 yards to Harrison Poole. And the rest of the offense celebrates as Jacksonville now leads 49-23. The second real deep shot of the game, Stoshak lost the first one against an open door. This one, though, in the middle of the field, no doors or walls for Harrison Poole to worry about. And number 14 goes for 40. And now Belcher on to make this a 50-23 game. Belcher's kick misses wide to the left. So it's a 26-point margin, but you'll take the response if you're Jacksonville. 49-23 the score. We'll be back in a moment here on YouTube Live.
Like to keep your beard perfectly groomed, but she hates all that mess. Now there's VacuTrim by Bell & Howell, the total body shaver that trims your hair and vacuums it up. VacuTrim stainless steel blades give you a precision cut, while the built-in vacuum captures the hair shavings. It has 20 trim settings to shape your beard and tame body hair with no mess. Get VacuTrim with free shipping for only $39.95.
Call 1-800-390-6404. That's 1-800-390-6404. Or go to VacuTrim.com.
Been cutting since 1990.
There's something special about cooking out in the backyard. Beautiful out here today. There's nothing like cooking home with your family and sharing food with the people that I love. Barbecue is all about bringing people together.
Because everybody loves barbecue.
You rip and tear your old statements and bills, but thieves use this information to steal your identity. Don't be a victim. Get the ID Police, the new ink roller that encrypts all your old documents. So before you throw it out, just roll it on, and your information is gone, both on the front and through the back. Even if the paper is held up to the light, even your medical information is safe with the ID Police. So block it out before you throw it out. Order now and get your ID Police for as low as $9.99 and get free shipping too. This offer is not available on Amazon, so call or click now to get your ID Police for as low as $9.99 with free shipping. Order now.
Call 1-800-519-9158. That's 1-800-519-9158. Or visit getidpolice.com. So call 1-800-519-9158 now.
We're back here on the Shark Tank, 49-23 after the 40-yard touchdown pass from Sam Castronova to Harrison Poole. Allowed the Sharks to respond to the Orlando touchdown and deuce. Belcher sends this kick away, and Prince will jump up, tip it off the net to himself. And he'll try the left side, get tackled there by Jabari Gorman. Solid kick coverage again for Jacksonville, and Orlando backed up to the 5-yard line. D. Armstrong Contracting does everything from procurement of land, purchase or lease, to architects, engineers, general contractors, and subcontractors, as well as all of their services necessary to build your next project. They specialize in small to mid-sized businesses looking to build and promise to save you as much as they can. Ball at the 6-yard line for Danny Southwick and the Predators. We hand it off to Desmond Maxwell again, who gets about 3 yards after getting hit by Jimmy Goodloe. Ended up falling forward with his momentum. I think that's rushing attempt number 14 of the night for Maxwell, which is something we haven't seen since the days of Derek Ross. Of course, a longtime Shark. Also a member of the Philadelphia Soul in the Arena Football League and in the NAL with Jacksonville. And Maxwell gets it again, and he'll get shoved backwards, and he fumbles it back to Southwick. And that's a disaster for Orlando, as they're going to lose about 6 yards on the play. Maxwell getting pushed backwards. I think his forward progress had just about been stopped, but the ball comes free, and he pitched it of his own volition back to Southwick. They're going to spot it up the 3-yard line, but it's still a loss of 7. And now 3rd down and 12 for Orlando. Long in motion. Southwick, his pass is incomplete. Darius Prince wants a flag. Nothing was coming. Looked like they could have gotten the high motion man offside as well. Southwick getting his play call. But right now, if you're Orlando, this could be it. You're down by 26. It's, yeah, you're still, you know, just about halfway through the third quarter, but you don't want to give Jacksonville the ball first and goal with the way that Castronova and the Sharks have been converting tonight. It's fourth and 12. Orlando needs to get just outside the 15-yard line. Darius Prince, the motion man. Southwick back to pass. Flag is down as he gets sacked by Trey Harlan. The ball comes out, and I think this one's going to get blown dead.
Offside, defense, number 77. 5-yard penalty, repeat fourth down.
They get Russell for the offside. That wipes away the Trey Harlan sack and potentially what could have been a fumble recovery in the end zone. It's still fourth and long for Orlando. Devin Wilson from his Jack linebacker spot getting the fans fired up. You've got Goodlow, Gilbert, Harlan, and Munoz coming after the quarterback. They announced 77 on the penalty, but Russell's not on the field. That was Trey Harlan, I think, called for offside. Either way, here comes fourth down. Southwick back to pass, steps up in the pocket under pressure, lets it go, it's picked off. That one is intercepted, and into the end zone is Harrison Poole. It's the Sharks' third pick six by three different players. Poole, who just caught a touchdown, gets in with an interception return, and Jacksonville leads 55-23. It's free wings for the fans in attendance with the Sharks getting 50 plus. Here's another look. Southwick just trying to make something happen. Poole saw that one coming all the way, and he gets in easily. Got a conversation with the officiating crew in front of Bill Alford, one of the Sharks' assistant coaches. Not entirely sure what they could be discussing here.
Prior to the pass being released, holding, defense, number one, 5-yard penalty from the previous spot, automatic, first down.
So an extremely delayed penalty call, as evidently there was defensive holding. Which is going to give the Predators a first down. Wipe away the pick six, and it's back to 49-23. So we'll see if Harrison Poole can do it again from his backside corner spot.
The foul for holding is 5 yards. This was not defensive pass interference. 5-yard penalty.
After confirming, they have the ball now in the right position of the 13-yard line.
All right, if I can get some noise from the beautiful people, I might appreciate it. Thanks.
Looks like we are finally set for action once again. As Southwick hands it off to Maxwell, running right. He'll get stacked up and dropped. Brandon Munoz on the tackle for Jacksonville. It's been Harlan and Munoz making a lot of things happen defensively for Jacksonville tonight.
Awesome.
At this point, Desmond Maxwell getting the ball is not a surprise. The Sharks have had some more success on Orlando's last few rushing attempts. Southwick back to pass this time. Fires to the right. That one pulled in by Lonnie Outlaw. Nice one-handed catch. Outlaw outreaching Devin Wilson for the football. Picks up the first down. Outlaw 6'7 frame, extending the right arm to about 8 or 9 feet in the air to pull that one in. Pitch to Maxwell, running left, and not a whole lot of running room to speak of. David Gilbert, the first man in for Jacksonville. Trey Harlan, as he has all game, finds himself near the bottom of the pile as well. Under four to play here in the third quarter. Orlando moving down the field with new life after the pick six by Harrison Poole taken off the board due to a hold. Southwick scrambles out of the pocket, throws to the right, and he'll just send that one into the fifth row. Bringing up second and 10. Good early push by the front four kind of disrupted the rhythm as Southwick had to roll out on that one. It's third and 9 for the Predators at the Jacksonville 19-yard line. Outlaw in motion. Deep drop for Southwick. Steps up, fires that one caught by Outlaw. First down yardage for the Predators. A gain of about 12 on third and 9. Moves Orlando inside the 10. It'll be first and goal. I think Jimmy Goodloe might have wanted something to be thrown as... looked like an offensive lineman had the hand around both shoulders, but it works out for Orlando. From the 8-yard line, the play clock winding down.
Delay of game, offense.
They'll flag Orlando for delay of game. That'll back the Predators up 5 yards. First and goal now from the 15. Florida Blue is more than an insurer. They're your health partner working to lower your costs, make your benefits easy to access, and providing you with a broad range of health services that include traditional medical care, mental well-being, preventative care, and so much more. Visit a Jacksonville Florida Blue Center to receive a complimentary Jacksonville Sharks gift. Under two left here in the third quarter. First and goal from the 13-yard line. Southwick takes the snap, looks left, under pressure, he goes down. The ball's out. Jacksonville has it. David Gilbert with the football, and it's Jacksonville's possession. Former Miami Hurricane David Gilbert falling on that football. It's first and 10 for the Sharks offense. Desmond Maxwell can't believe it. Here's another look. Southwick taken down. I think it was Goodloe there going low. Trey Harlan high. Gilbert grabbing the football. I'm not sure if he was contacted there, but didn't seem too interested in standing up and trying to continue to run it. Honestly, probably a smart play there by the defensive lineman. Just secure the football, get it to your offense, and keep it moving. So Jacksonville presumably is going to take this down in a couple of plays to the end of the quarter, barring a touchdown on this snap, which is entirely possible. The challenge flag is on the field, which is why the players are now back in their respective sideline areas talking to the coaches. Not sure if Orlando thinks that maybe Southwick was down.
The ruling on the field was the quarterback fumbled, subsequently recovered by Jacksonville. Orlando is challenging that the quarterback was down by contact. This play is under further review.
So if you heard the announcement there by Aaron West, Orlando is going to challenge contending that Danny Southwick was down.
Did you have the previous spot?
That's what I need to look at. I think it's a 12. I think we were at the 7. We went back 5 on the on the delay. So I think it's a 12.
Just give me the start of the play, please. And can you give me the sideline view at the start there?
13.
Okay, so the previous spot 13. is the 13. Okay, go ahead and roll it, please. That's the plus 13.
You can't see where the ball comes.
That's pretty inconclusive.
Angle?
You got another angle?
Here we go.
Yeah, let's have this angle.
So we're getting a look over the shoulder of the officiating crew here.
Knee down. I think his knee's down.
Right there. Frame it right there.
Back.
Can you backpedal it here? Hold on. Right there. That's good.
Got it.
That's good. Okay. So hold on before we go.
We need to see what the yard line is.
We need to see the yard line on it.
Go back to the high 50.
Guys, we're going to overturn this. This was not a fumble. We're going to spot the ball at the
19.
At the plus 19. What down?
It'll be second down.
Plus 19.
That was first down.
Plus 19, second down.
Run it back.
Can you run it back? No, there we go. First. So it's going to be first and goal at the 19, second and goal at the 19.
So if you heard the announcement there, they're going to rule that Southwick's knee was down, and that moves the ball back to the 19. So the sack for Goodloe will stand,
after
but Orlando will
review,
keep possession.
The ruling on the field has changed. The quarterback's knee was clearly down with indisputable video evidence at the 19. The ball will be spotted at the 19-yard line. It will be second down, Orlando. Orlando is not charged with the timeout and has one remaining challenge.
This is disgusting.
.102 left in the third quarter, 49-23. Still the score, Orlando with a possession that is seemingly never going to end, as we've had two Jacksonville turnovers overturned, one by penalty, that one by the challenge. You did see the officiating crew get a pretty good look at it with that camera right behind the play. So as we tick into the final minute of this third quarter, the Predators now have second and goal all the way back at the 19-yard line. Fuentes, the motion man for Southwick, and this one's going to get blown dead. I think Jeremiah Price might have gotten a jump a bit too quick.
Neutral zone infraction. Defense, number 9, unabated to the quarterback. This is the defense's fourth foul in this game for Jacksonville. By rule, they are in the bonus. First down, Orlando.
So that's going to give the Predators a first and 10 because it was the fourth defensive penalty by Jacksonville. And they're going to have to run the chains back onto the field because it was second and goal from the 19. And now it's first and 10 from the 14-yard line. So they hand it off to Maxwell. What a surprise on that first down. 3-yard gain. That moves it down to the 11-yard line, and that may be the final play of the third quarter. We'll see how much of a hurry Orlando is in. Tackle there by Jimmy Goodloe, who's made an impact on these last few plays. The Predators break the huddle. 5 seconds left. They're looking up, and they're not in too much of a hurry. I think Southwick is just going to let this one go, and time does expire. So Orlando has had the ball for about the last 8 minutes. They still have the opportunity to get a first down when we come back. So that's the end of the third. It's 49-23. We'll step aside, come back for the final 15 minutes here. Momentarily, you're watching Jacksonville Sharks football on YouTube Live.
Are you looking for a place to host your next corporate outing, date night, family fun night? Sharks have you covered. Sharks Reef Field Suites are the most exciting place to watch a sporting event here in Jacksonville. You can't get any closer to the action. Each Reef Suite includes food and holds up to 8 people. Create memories you'll never forget. Give me a call, 904-621-0700, extension 702, or email me, Dave@jacksharks.com, to secure your Reef Suite. I promise you, these will sell out, so don't delay. Purchase your Reef Suite today.
Locally owned and operated for over 60 years, Tom Neal is your number one source for heavy-duty trucks, parts, and service to get you and your load where you need to go. A certified dealer for Freightliner, Western Star, Volvo, and Isuzu, we know trucks. Stop by any of our Jacksonville, Lake City, or Waycross locations, or visit TomNeal.com.
We're ready for battle for ourselves and for you. A season of excitement and fun with the Sharks is here. We're prepared. Now it's fins up in the Shark Tank, leaving it all on the field. And it's you, our fans, who give us the strength to fight for victory and our final goal. Your Jacksonville Sharks are back, and they're chasing a ship. Get your tickets today.
Yo, I get them camera phones out. I need to see every flashlight on right now. Wipe them camera phones right now! Let me see it! Light this arena up, baby! Oh, that's beautiful, Jacksonville. Duval!
Final 15 minutes of play here in the Shark Tank. 49-23 is the score. Orlando's extended possession now at a 2nd down and 7 from the 11-yard line. About halfway through the third quarter, Harrison Poole had an interception return for a touchdown taken back. Due to a penalty, there was a sack fumble overturned, at least the fumble portion, Now Orlando trying to cash in. Southwick under pressure lets this one go. That's over everything into about the seventh row toward the Orlando bench. Make that third down and seven. It's been mostly Danny Southwick's game. We did see Rakeem Cato for a series in the second quarter, which ended up in a turnover on downs. Have not seen Cato since then. And Southwick been the man at the helm here in the second half. Darius Prince in motion, third down and seven. Flags are flown, and this one is blown dead.
Delay of game, offense, and failed to identify. 5-yard penalty, repeat third down.
Delay of game and a tight end failing to identify called against the Predators there. It's the second delay game on this series, and it's now third down and 12 from the 17-yard line. Long the motion man, Southwick deep drop, throws over the middle. That one is batted away by Jabari Gorman, and it's fourth and long coming up for Orlando. Gorman open tonight with a pick six. He's made some solid tackles. Comes up with that deflection there. Just a perfectly timed cut by Gorman. Getting in front of the receiver and a clean swipe with the right hand.
Timeout, Jacksonville. This is their first charge timeout of the half.
The Sharks call timeout just to make sure they have everything under control here on this fourth down snap. For over 45 years, Southern Furniture Leasing has provided quality rental furniture at competitive prices. They pride themselves on their customer service, amazing selection, and speed of delivery. Whether you need corporate, residential, or student housing furniture packages, the Southern Furniture Leasing team has the right selection of value you're looking for. Southern Furniture Leasing invites you to explore their wide selection of top quality furnishings. The last points of this game were that 40-yard bomb from Sam Castronova to Harrison Poole. Orlando has extended their possession on a number of occasions on this drive, getting a couple of first downs via penalty. Jacksonville certainly making them work for it, and the Sharks have a chance to really put themselves in a good spot with what would be their fifth defensive stop of the game if they can come up with one here. The Predators can get a first down at about the 4-yard line. They'll have Darius Prince in motion here on fourth and long. Castronova steps up in the pocket, looking, throws to the corner. It's intercepted by Gorman, his second of the night, and Jacksonville takes over.
Holding, offense, number 65. Penalty is declined. Result of the play, first down, Jacksonville.
Hold called against the offense. That clearly declined by the Sharks, and they'll take it over on after the turnover with that interception. Second of the night for the league leader in picks. Now 8 on the season for Jabari Gorman. And a chance for Castronova and the offense to extend the margin even more here. Ten seconds on the play clock, but plenty of time for Jacksonville to get going here. Stoshak, the motion man, Castronova, quick pass out to Solomon. Gets a block from Stoshak. Cameron Solomon out to about the 20-yard line. Solid drive starter and a first down for Jacksonville. At this point, the name of the game for Jacksonville is no mistakes. Keep moving the chains, keep that clock running, try and get some more points. The way your defense has been playing, you're pretty confident, but you can always do more on offense as well. Another quick pass to Solomon. Another block on the edge by Stoshak. Cameron Solomon for 14 yards. It's another efficient game for Sam Castronova, spreading the ball around. We've seen Solomon, as well as Devin Wilson, with several catches. Harrison Poole, the big touchdown. Stoshak has had an opportunity or two as well. Another quick pass to Solomon, another block by Stoshak. The Predators, though, in a different defense, had another guy over there. So not quite as much running room for Solomon this time. But he picks up about 4 yards. Tevin Homer on the stop. Up in Greensboro, the Carolina Cobras have extended the margin. That was a 25-21 game at one point recently. It's now 45-28, Cobras over the Gunslingers. Carolina trying to improve to 8-4 and claw their way toward the number two seed in the NAL standings. Wilson in motion, second down for Jacksonville. The pass is up, and that one's batted down by Long. The incompletions are few and far between for Castronova tonight, but there's one there, and it's now third down at about 6. On third down, Castronova settles in the pocket, throws left. That one is intercepted. Joshua Jenkins picks it off, and finally it was going to happen one way or another. Sam Castronova throws his first interception as a Jacksonville Shark, and it took a great play by Joshua Jenkins, who cuts in front of Stoshak and pulls that one in. It's a touchback, and we will step aside. So 10:03 to go, 49-23, still the score. We'll be back in a moment here on YouTube Live.
Sharks fans, are you looking for something new to do at a Sharks game? Book a Sharks party deck. Enjoy a spacious party deck with great view on game day. Handpick one of our party deck food packages. If you like good food, fun, and football, try Sharks party deck at our next home game. Book your Sharks party deck today. Call David Gleason at 904-621-0700, extension 702, or email him at dave@jacksharks.com. Make sure to tell them the attack sent you.
We're in the heart of Springfield, that close to downtown in Jacksonville. You can either stop by. We're at 1501 North Main Street. We service the Jacksonville area. Our clients are people who are busy moms, busy dads, families, career-driven people who don't have the time to cook at home, or who just like the convenience of someone prepping and cooking their meals. I put love into my food, and everyone says that they can taste the love. You can order online at readyprepgo.online. We are also on social media.
Hey Sharks fans, plan your next big night out at a Sharks game. We have a wide range of group night options to make your night a perfect night out. So whether you're a business, a club, a team, or just a large family that wants to have a good time, the Sharks have you covered. Visit our website, jacksharks.com, to see all of our affordable options, and you can even fill out a request form at jacksharks.com. You can book an event or give Dave a call at 904 621-0700, extension 702, or email dave@jacksharks.com. Remember, we create memories, and your event will never get delayed or made.
Back in the tank after the Jenkins interception, Orlando will start this drive from the 10-yard line. 10:03 to play in the ball game, now ticking under 10 minutes. They'll hand it off to Nick Haig this time. Haig gets about 3 yards. We've seen a lot of that from the Predators tonight. First down handoffs. Generally positive yardage, but with the exception of one or two from Desmond Maxwell, not a whole lot in terms of big yardage. The 26-point lead for Jacksonville. Time certainly on the Sharks' side. We'll have this running clock all the way to the one-minute timeout. Southwick under pressure lets this one go. It's deep. It's incomplete. Eric McIntosh down there in coverage on Darius Prince. Prince asking for a flag, and McIntosh says not today. Now third down for the Predators. The Sharks have had 5 defensive stops tonight, and that's a big reason they've got this 26-point lead. 3 interceptions, 2 by Jabari Gorman, 1 by Marvin Ross. Gorman and Ross each have a pick 6. You also had a safety toward the end of the first half, as well as a garden variety turnover on downs. Now 3rd and 7, long in motion. Southwick under pressure, chased down and sacked by Russell inside the 10-yard line. It's 4th and long. A receiving touchdown as a tight end, and now a sack for Russell. As it's 4th and 11 for Orlando, and Jacksonville's defense continues to set the tone tonight. The Predators need the 20-yard line. They're at their own 9. On 4th down, Southwick under pressure, chased down by Price. He's going to get sacked. The ball's out. And who's got it? They're going to say that it's at about the 1-yard line. So it's Jacksonville football either way. Here's another look at that one. Southwick under pressure. Goodlow from the front side is the first one in. And then it gets cleaned up by Price. They rule it down at the 1. That's where Jacksonville takes over. Check that. They'll spot it at the 2. But either way, good position for Castronova and the Shark offense. That's now 6 stops for the Sharks defense tonight. Castronova, a chance to seal the game here. 1st and goal from the 2. Smith in motion, they'll hand it off, and he's going to go backwards, stay on his feet, and fight his way back, but end up losing about 1.5 yards on the play. Bryant Smith, probably the best size of any receiver for Jacksonville, but unable to get in there. If nothing else, it uses about 40 seconds between the play, the resetting of the ball, and then the winding of the play clock, and you'll take that at this point if you're Jacksonville. The Sharks have scored 50 points in every game this season. That is somewhat in jeopardy, although they just need one more. Now 2nd and goal. Castronova looking for Smith, and that one incomplete, but there's a flag. Clear defensive pass interference or a hold. Either way, that contact against Orlando, and this should be 1st and goal now for Jacksonville.
Pass interference, defense, number 1. Penalized half the distance to the goal, automatic, 1st down.
Trey Long called for 1st down, or called for 1st down. Called for pass interference, and that's an automatic 1st down for Jacksonville. So we're basically back to where this drive started. Maybe a foot further for Jacksonville. They're now at the 1.5, we'll call it. Castronova looking for Solomon. That one batted down at the line, incomplete. But again, another 40 seconds can come off the clock here if you're Jacksonville. Poole to the left, Smith to the right. Solomon in motion here for Jacksonville. They hand it out to Anthony Johnson. Running right, Johnson stretching over the goal line and into the end zone. It's the second total touchdown and first rushing tonight for Anthony Johnson as the Sharks finally get that 55-point. We thought they had it about a quarter ago, but now finally with 6 minutes left in the fourth, the Sharks back on the board. It's 55-23, and this one is pretty much over, given a 32-point margin here. Initial block by Russell, and really Johnson just using his balance and speed and strength to fight off the tackle, stretch into the goal line. Castronova puts the ball down. Belcher's kick up and good. And that makes it 56-23 with 5:32 to go in the ball game.
Hey, Josh.
Talk to me.
I didn't even want to say this, but we got a Super Bowl champion and the former Pro Bowler came to support your Jacksonville Sharks. Shout out to my brother Cliff Averill and the Cliff Averill Family Foundation.
Hey, not just that, a former Clay High School Blue Devil. What's going
on? Come on, somebody.
You know what it is.
Now, let's get to business. Concerned Veterans for America wanted me to throw out some shirts. So guess what? I'm going to throw out some shirts. So sections 103 and sections 114. I want to see who's going to get the loudest. Duval! Come on now! Duval! I ain't gonna lie, y'all picked the right. Just 103, what's up? Let them things go! Y'all know I'm gonna show some love.
It's Military Appreciation Night as the Sharks take on the West Texas Warbirds in the Bi-Star Veterans Memorial Arena.
Enjoy a great game and then meet me, my teammates, and the attack on the field for our post-game autograph session, sponsored by Showtime Sports, Cards, and Collectibles.
For tickets, give our ticket team a call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com.
We're back here in the tank, 5:32 to go. 56-23 is the margin. It's the Jacksonville defense setting the tone all game long. The two pick sixes in the first quarter. A couple of stops here in the second half as well. An interception by Jabari Gorman in both the first and fourth. A couple of turnovers on downs. Tyu largely keep the Predators out of the end zone. And how you get to a 33-point lead. Belcher sends this one away, and that one is way wide, so it's going to be a 32-point lead as that kick will give Orlando a free point.
Illegal kick out of bounds. Kicking team, number 20. The spot of the foul would have been the 6-yard line. By rule, the ball will be spotted at the 10-yard line, left college hash, first down, Orlando. 1 point is awarded to Orlando.
Discover the South Bank Hotel at Jacksonville Riverwalk, a downtown hotel drawing inspiration from the St. Johns River ports and area bridges, providing an authentic Northeast Florida experience. This centrally located hotel is nestled on the South Bank of downtown Jacksonville, near the trendy San Marco and Riverside Historic Districts. Experience the coastal undercurrents and feel the hospitality when you stay at the South Bank Hotel at Jacksonville Riverwalk. Danny Southwick and the Predators down by 32. 5:15 and counting in the ballgame. Southwick's pass batted down by Munoz and nearly intercepted by Renfro. Several deflections by the Shark defense, a few by the line. Renfro had one earlier. Here Munoz gets both hands up, deflects it, and Justin Renfro trying to make something happen. Charging toward the ball, but it does hit the turf. The West Texas Warbirds will be here in the tank next week. Quick pass out to the left side. That one caught by Prince, a gain of about 4 yards. Jacksonville's largely done a great job of shutting down anything deep. Orlando's really had to matriculate its way down the field whenever they have had success, and that's given the defense opportunities to make other plays. Partially responsible for the pick sixes and the turnovers on downs. 4 minutes left. This one caught in space, and it's a first down for the Predators as Gerard Cook thought he was still going, but he did get tackled against the wall right at midfield. Latest update from Greensboro is 53-28 Cobras over the Gunslingers. So if that margin holds, Jacksonville would be 9-2, San Antonio 8-3, Carolina 8-4. And this pitch is going nowhere but backwards as Jeremiah Price read that one like a book as Maxwell taken down. And it's second and long for Orlando. At this point, the Sharks have seen this sweep about 6 or 7 times. And Price just ran outside of the block knowing what was coming. Southwick under pressure, and he'll lose the football. Orlando's going to hang on to it, but I think David Gilbert got the strip sack as Jacksonville's defense coming alive up front here. Gilbert flexing on him with that sack, and it's now third down at about 18 yards.
Timeout, Orlando. This is their first charge timeout of the half.
Orlando calling timeout here. Just trying to reorient themselves. So that game in Greensboro is in the fourth quarter. Carolina up by 25 points. Again, 53-28 in the fourth. So I think it's fairly safe to say at this point that Carolina will come away with a win. So again, to reset after tonight's action with these results mostly decided, Jacksonville alone in first place, they'll be 9-2. San Antonio will fall to 8-3, losing their second consecutive game. The Carolina Cobras suddenly hot. Their third straight win will move them up to 8-4. And then Orlando will fall to 4-7 with West Texas idle this week, remaining at 2-10. The interesting quirk of the schedule here in these final few weeks is there's going to be a rematch between Carolina and San Antonio next week. That one out in Texas. It's a Saturday afternoon affair kicking off at 3 p.m. local. And if you're the Cobras, you're thinking, well, all right, here's our chance to at least for the moment jump ahead. Because Carolina at 8-4 facing what would be an 8-3 gunslinger team. Well, if you can win your second straight game against the same opponent, you would then end up at 9-4. They'd fall to 8-4. So the Cobras trying to rally late here in this season, picking up a couple of wins before they come or before they host Jacksonville in the final week. Southwick lets this one go. It's caught by Cook. Poole on the tackle. It's going to be well short of the first down. Call it 4th-and-7 coming up here for Orlando. Once again, Southwick under pressure. It was Munoz coming in from behind, but good job by Cook getting some action here in this fourth quarter. Pulled in a couple of catches recently. Fourth down, this could be the last offensive play for Orlando tonight. Fuentes in motion. Southwick under pressure, lets it go. Fuentes has the catch. That's a first down for Orlando, and he'll get taken into the wall by Marvin Ross at just about the 10-yard line. So I think we're going to get a first and goal, and this will be the one-minute timeout here momentarily. So 60 seconds left. The Sharks comfortably in front by 32. We will step aside for a quick break and be right back here on YouTube Live.
Each team has 2 timeouts. By rule, all timeouts will be 30 seconds. Each team may still challenge. Standard timing rules will apply. Timeout for immediate timeout.
Hey, Shark Nation. This is your ticket guy, David Dyer. If you're a local business owner, we want to turn our fans into your newest customers. I have an offer for you. Jorge's partnerships are a great way to get your company name and information in front of all our fans in the Shark Tank. We are also going to reward you with a year-round digital advertising on our website and provide you with a promotional table for your business at each Sharks game. Plus, you'll receive season tickets for your business to provide to your family, staff, and even potential clients. If you want to become a Jaws partner this season, I can hook you up. Just call me, 904-621-0700, extension 717, or you can go online at jacksharks.com and fill out.
Real estate title work and title insurance is often viewed as a boring and tedious part of a real estate closing on a property. Our business tagline? Focused, fun, deals done. We take what we do very seriously, but derive satisfaction from making the closing process a positive and worry-free experience for both the buyer and the seller. So if you're looking to close on a property, come to Titletown. We'll show you around.
Final minute of action. This one essentially decided. Jacksonville set the tone on defense, took an early lead that they have not relinquished. It's 56-24 here with 60 seconds left in the game. Orlando has never led tonight. This game was tied briefly at 7-7, and then Orlando had a kickoff out of bounds, which was actually when Jacksonville took the lead for good at 8-7. The Shark defense has set the tone tonight. Quick pass here from Southwick on first down for Prince, as Prince gets along the wall, and there's now 49 seconds left. And because of the margin of this game, they will wind the clock, so not the typical 1 minute timing rules given Jacksonville's up by 32 points here. Clock right at about 30 seconds. Southwick pitches it to Maxwell one more time, and why not? Munoz and Price there on the stop, and that might do it, although I think Orlando's going to call timeout. And they do, so Orlando wants at least one more snap here.
Timeout, Orlando. This is their second charge timeout of the half. By rule, this is a 30-second timeout.
So we mentioned it a few times, but the Sharks will be back here in the tank for their regular season home finale, taking on the West Texas Warbirds. Jacksonville's now won 5 consecutive home games after starting the season with 2 straight overtime 1-point home losses. But since then, after that second loss against Orlando, the season changed when, of course, Sam Castronova made his way down here to Jacksonville. And the Sharks will move to 7-0 with Castronova at the helm tonight. 21 seconds left, Orlando trying to get something. And they won't on this play, as that is Jeremiah Price and Justin Renfro taking down Southwick.
10, 9, 8, 7.
And Southwick and the Predators are scrambling if they want to run one more play. And I don't think they're going to get one off, as time finally expires, and that'll do it.
That's the end of the game.
Justin Renfro waves goodbye to the Predators as Jacksonville takes down Orlando by a 56-24 margin. It's the Sharks' 7th straight win. They extend their streak of scoring at least 50 points in every game this season. In fact, 54 or more in every contest here in 2023. This is also the fewest points the Sharks have allowed in a game this season. The defense gets it done. 3 interceptions, 2 turnovers on downs, and a safety, setting the tone. Sam Castronova did throw his first interception as a Shark, but now has a 40-1 touchdown to interception ratio, which you will take at any time. So the Sharks win 56-24. Again, their fourth consecutive home win, and 7th win in a row overall. So that's going to just about do it for us here tonight, as we'll have one more regular season broadcast here for you next week as the West Texas Warbirds come to town before the Sharks then head up to Greensboro to take on potentially a second place Carolina Cobras team in 2 weeks' time to close out the regular season. So want to thank the Jacksonville Sharks for giving us this opportunity to bring the action to you. Want to thank the team behind the scenes on the cameras and in the production crew getting this looking and sounding great throughout the entire course of the game. And I want to thank you, the listener, for and viewer, for tuning in and checking out the action. We, of course, always hope to see you in the tank, but if you can't make it, we're glad to have you along here with us. I have been Xander Keene bringing the action again. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next Saturday night as the Sharks take on the West Texas Warbirds coming up here on YouTube Live.